everyone, welcome to Nadia at Maji's YouTube channel. So in this episode, I'm taking you through Cambridge. This is the city where the Cambridge University is. So we're definitely going to the university and to several colleges probably. So stay tuned. Morning train from Liverpool Station, London. The ticket cost £12 sterling with the railcard discount. It took just about 1.5 hours to Cambridge from London. I started the Cambridge day trip in Cambridge University Botanic Garden. The garden was founded in 1762 in the center of the city. Cambridge University Botanic Garden holds a collection of over 8,000 plant species from all over the world to facilitate teaching and research. The garden provides resources including plant material, horticultural expertise, and facilities to research workers and lecturers. Since its foundation, however, the garden has also provided a beautiful place for everybody to enjoy and benefit from a series of wonderful landscapes through which to discover the drama of plant diversity. The winter garden consists of colored stems, bark, and foliage texture with winter flowers and fragrance until mid-spring. And then, here we are at the scented garden. It has been a feature of the garden since 1960, when it was designed to demonstrate the diverse range of scents and aromas produced by plants. All the plants featured here have either scented flowers to attract pollinators or fragrant foliage to deter predators. A stroll through the scented garden offers the opportunity to pick out the scent of individual species. The glass house offers year-round interest and include plants ranging from diminutive high-altitude alpines to impressive tropical trees. Each of the glass houses in the range is themed to highlight plant adaptations, habitats, and associations in a diversity of environments. One of the main attractions in the Cambridge Botanical Garden is the glass house, and here's one of my favorite plants, the cactus. So amazing. There are so many variants of cactus here. Yeah, don't forget to go to the glass house.
Plants of arid landscapes have adapted to low rainfall, existing in places where rain may not fall for many years, and also to extreme temperatures, where the daytime temperature can be as high as 50 degrees Celsius, dropping to below freezing at night. The plants in this house show how they cope in these conditions. Some of the species grown here are succulent and store water in fleshy leaves or swollen stems. Many are globe or barrel shaped to maximize their capacity to store water. Many have either no leaves or very small leaves, or spines to minimize evaporation. The landscaping here resembles a dry riverbed, and the plants grown here come from Africa and America. Now it's time for lunch. We had lunch at one of the most famous and historical pubs at Cambridge, the Eagle. It is famous because it was the place where scientists Francis Crick and James Watson interrupted lunchtime here to announce the discovery of the DNA structure. How cool is that? So I'm currently at the Eagle. You must try halloumi. This is a cheese, but it's fried. So yeah, this is the cheese. Let's try this. It's tasty.
This pub is also known as a place for airmen to drink and socialize in World War II. During the war period, they doodle their names onto the ceiling with fire from candle. After we eat, we witnessed the Corpus clock. The Corpus clock, also known as the Grasshopper clock, is a large sculptural clock at the city center. Cambridge tour won't be complete without a college tour. We're lucky to have one of Cambridge master students, Narswari, who is part of Emmanuel College, to be our tour guide.
I'm in Emmanuel Cambridge, also known as Emma.
Emma is a short name for Emmanuel. It was one of the old colleges in Cambridge, and we're about to enter the chapel, which was designed by Christopher Wren, one of a famous architect in the UK. I think he also designed St. Paul Church in London, so we're about to go here. The chapel is open during the day, do come in.
So here's the chapel.
Here you can see a lot of former masters and alumni, and one of them is John Harvard, which is the founder of Harvard University in the US.
Now we're heading to Cambridge Market. Traders have been running stalls at the historic market square in the city center since the Middle Ages. It is open for trading from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. every day except Christmas Day, Boxing Day, and New Year's Day. You can buy fresh food and ingredients from a wide range of cuisines, as well as art, plants, clothes, jewelry, books, music, and much more. Some traders are able to offer services such as bike and watch repair. Since we went to Cambridge during winter, the day moved past very quickly and it got dark in the afternoon. So to end the trip, we had dessert in the new Heavenly Dessert restaurant. The luxury dessert restaurant has been tantalizing taste buds since 2008, serving a range of treats including chocolate shots, sundaes, waffles, croffles, and milkshakes. The price is very affordable. This croffle only cost me around £8 sterling.